The back of the thigh is the entrance wound, and the front is the exit. If that's the case, the victim was shot. Yes, the shooter was behind the victim when she was shot. The entrance and exit wounds tell us what happens when someone has been shot. In this case, the victim was shot in the... Yes, the bullet entered through the chest, creating the entrance GSW. It then passed through her body and out her back, creating the exit GSW. This proves that she had been shot from the front. In any case, the wound in the thigh isn't the same size as the wound in the chest. Could this mean that two different firearms were used? I think contacting Little Guy and asking him to look into this would be my best option here. Little Guy, analyze this wound.
Understood. This is a penetrating bullet wound from a firearm?
That's right. Rosalia was shot.
A bullet entered her chest and went through her heart. I don't think there was any doubt that this was a fatal wound.
I see. The question now is who pulled the trigger? Little Guy, could you analyze this hypostasis?
Yes, of course. Please send your data over to me.
All right. Please look at it right away.
Okay, I've got it. Let's see here. Well, the hypostasis matches the position Rosalia's body was in when she was discovered.
Hypostasis occurs when the blood flow throughout the body has stopped. The blood settles within the corpse, pooling in the areas closest to the ground. Thus, Rosalia's corpse was... Yes. If the corpse had been moved, the hypostasis wouldn't match the position we discovered the body in. That place truly is where Rosalia drew her last breath.
Oh, Dr. Kimishima? I have a question.
Hopefully it's something I have an answer for. What is it?
Well, the blue flowers are only growing in that one particular area of the field. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right. Rosalia was found in the center of this area of blue flowers.
Well, isn't that too much to be coincidence? It just seems so set up.
I see. What you're trying to say is...
Yes. Doesn't that make more sense?
You may have a point. Hypostasis begins to appear roughly 30 minutes after death. It's possible that her corpse was moved here immediately after she died to create this situation.
If that's the case, why would her killer do such a thing to her?
We're just grasping at straws here. We'll need real evidence and facts in order to solve these mysteries. Little Guy, can you analyze these black particles?
Okay. This is gunshot residue.
Gunshot residue.
When a gun is fired, it launches more than the bullet. Particles of gunpowder are blasted out of the barrel by the force of the explosion as well. When those particles land on the target being shot at, it is known as gunshot residue.
I see. So, since it was on Rosalia, that means... indeed. It would indicate that she was shot from very close range. Hey, little guy, I need you to analyze this gunshot wound.
Yes, ma'am. A gunshot wound to the palm, I see. The bullet entered through the palm and exited through the back of the hand. It seems she was raising her hand towards the gun when it was fired.
Why would she put her hand up like that? A defensive wound is damage taken while trying to protect oneself from harm. She likely put her hands up as an instinctive reaction to having a gun pointed at her.
Recording started August 7th. 2 days ago, I verified the sample collected from the biopsy. I have succeeded in extracting the virus and will begin cultivating it as a sample. Compared to the mononegaviralis, there are 24 similarities found, and...
Dad! Hey, Dad! Sheesh!
Rose! Give that back!
No! It's time for dinner!
Oh, is it? I didn't even notice. I'm sorry.
Sheesh, you never hear me when you're working. No more work for you until we're done eating.
Well, you got me. I accept my defeat. All right, let's go to the dining room. What's for dinner today?
Yeah! Dinner, dinner!
Hey, don't run! You'll trip and hurt yourself! Hey, don't run! You'll trip and hurt yourself!